Dear friends, now let us make relative clauses. Let us see the examples and we shall learn how to make relative clauses in an easy manner. First of all, let us see the first letter. Mumbai is a large city. It lies to the west of India. The first thing we have to do is that we have to identify the correlatives in these two sentences. The correlatives means the same nouns or pronouns which are present in both the sentences. And in the first sentence, there is a mention about Mumbai, and Mumbai is a city. In the second sentence, Mumbai or city is equal to the word it. So here a noun is used and here a pronoun is used. Therefore, these two are the correlatives. Now, according to the grammar language, we will call the first relative as antecedent. Antecedent. It is called as antecedent. And it is the second relative, and mostly we have to improve making the clauses by touching the second sentence. Now, let us start with the second sentence. First of all, we have identified what are the relatives we have seen. We have identified that they are names of cities. One is noun and the other is pronoun. Now, we shall start making relative clause. Mostly, the second sentence is converted into a relative clause. For that purpose, we will provide a relative pronoun to the second word, that is it. So we will delete it and we will write that, because it comes in the category of things. So from that category we can take either that or which. Now, by writing that in place of it, we have automatically made the relative clause. So this is the first thing we have to do. We are automatically making the relative clause. And now our duty is to add this part of the sentence we have made to the main part. So the main part is here, Mumbai is a large city. So we shall write the answer as, Mumbai is a large city that lies to the west of India. Here, the thing which we have to remember is, the relative pronoun which we are providing should be nearer to the antecedent. That means city that. Suppose we are writing the complete sentence, and then by combining, we should give attention to the fact that the relative pronoun should be nearer to the antecedent. That means the noun in the first sentence which is equal to that of the relative pronoun. Now let us see one more sentence. I know a famous advocate. He will fight your case. He will fight your case. Yeah, I know a famous advocate. He will fight your case. So now let us find out who are the correlatives. Here the mention is about advocate. Here advocate is equalized by the word he. So this is noun and this is the pronoun. So these are two are correlatives. Now we will find out which relative pronoun is suitable for he. So he is a pronoun and he is the subject of the sentence. Therefore, we have to bring who, and he comes under the category of human beings. Therefore, we have to delete. By deleting, we have to provide who. So who will replace the word who can replace he or she, he or she, whatever the singular subject is there. As per the rule, we have to find out the proper relative pronoun. If the subject is he or she, then we can write who. So our sentence is, I know a famous advocate who will fight your case. In this condition, the two terms, advocate and who, they go together. In the previous sentence, city and that, they go together. So relations are established here. Now let us see the third sentence. We talked with a man. His financial condition is poor. Here, let us see. What is the mention about this sentence? It is about a man. And the equal of man here is his financial condition. But the word used here is his. His, there is difference between he and his. He is the subject form and his is the possessive form. So we have to delete this his and we have to find out which relative pronoun can be used here. So when we are deleting his, again this his comes under the category of human beings. Therefore, equal to the word his is the word whose. His is a possessive form and whose is also a possessive form. Therefore, we shall delete his and we shall make the second sentence, convert the second sentence into a relative clause. By writing whose financial condition is poor, we have automatically made the relative clause. And now we are adding the relative clause to the main sentence. Now here, whose and man both are the antecedent and the pronoun. Now let us see one more sentence. I have met the student. The collector awarded him. Here the mention is about the student. Sometimes students may misunderstand that the mention is about I. No. I, if I is there, then I should be repeated somewhere here also. There is no repetition. Here the noun is the student and here comes collector. But there is no mention about collector here. Therefore, this is not the equivalent or this is not the relative. Now, we are coming to the relative is here, him. And him means the student. The student is the noun and him is the pronoun. This is the object form and this is also the object form. Therefore, we will delete him. Him is also from the family of persons for which we are using either who or whose or whom. Now here the him, the used here is after the verb awarded. Therefore it is considered to be the object form. So in order to replace the object form, we have to use whom. But this whom should be used at the beginning of the relative clause. Why? Because then only we can establish the relation between the antecedent and the pronoun. So our answer will be, I have met the student whom the collector awarded. In this way, we shall make relative clauses. Let us see more examples.
दोस्तों ध्यान दें, हम relative clause बनाते हैं जब आप ध्यान दें दोनों sentences में से जो repeated है, जो nouns pronouns है उसको ढूंढ लें और उसमें से second sentence के pronoun को पहचान लें. यदि वो pronoun यदि persons की category में है तो हमको who, whose, whom में से एक का use करना है. उसको delete करते हुए उसके equal जो word है उसका प्रयोग करना है. और यदि वो किसी इंसान के लिए है तो उसको, जैसे सेकंड सेंटेंस में एडवोकेट और ही, ये दोनों आपस में रिलेटेड है और ये रिलेटिव्स है. ग्रामर में ये फर्स्ट वाला जो नाम है इसको एंटीसिडेंट नाम दिया गया है और सेकंड वाले को इसको प्रोनाउन नाम दिया गया है या नाउन नाम दिया गया है. तो हम इसको हटाएंगे और उसकी जगह पर प्रॉपर वर्ड को लिखेंगे. ही का प्रॉपर वर्ड होगा हु. एंड जब हम सेंटेंस बनाएंगे तो ये हु, एडवोकेट, ये दोनों साथ साथ रहेंगे. यहाँ पर दैट और सिटी, ये दोनों साथ साथ रहेंगे, तभी आपस में ये रिलेशन स्थापित कर पाएंगे. आप तीसरा सेंटेंस देखिए, वी टॉक्ड विथ अ मैन, हिज फिनेंशियल कंडीशन इज पुअर. यहाँ पर मैन की बात हो रही है और मैन के बराबर की बराबरी करने वाला शब्द हिस है. हिस सब्जेक्ट नहीं है, ये पोसेसिव फॉर्म है. इस कारण से हिस का इक्वल whose का प्रयोग करना पड़ेगा और ये whose ये man के साथ रह करके ये सेंटेंस को रिलेटिव क्लॉज में चेंज कर देते हैं. फोर्थ सेंटेंस देखिए, आई हैव मेट द स्टूडेंट, द कलेक्टर अवार्डेड हिम. हियर स्टूडेंट्स के बारे में बात हो रही है और यहाँ पर हिम की बात हो रही है और ये स्टूडेंट और हिम समान है, एक ही है. यहाँ पर स्टूडेंट ऑब्जेक्ट के स्थान पर है, यहाँ पर हिम ऑब्जेक्ट के स्थान पर है। अब ऑब्जेक्ट के स्थान पर जो हिम आया हुआ है इसको हम डिलीट करेंगे तो इसकी जगह इसके बराबरी करने वाला शब्द होगा हुम, और ये हुम यहाँ नहीं लिखेंगे, हम इसको यहाँ ले आएंगे तभी हम इसको इससे पहले आए हुए एंटीसीडेंट से जोड़ करके हम रिलेटिव क्लॉज ढंग से बना पाएंगे। हम हमेशा ये ध्यान दें कि हम मोस्टली सेकेंड सेंटेंसेस को बनाना शुरू कर दें, सेकेंड सेंटेंसेस के रिलेटिव प्रोनाउन यूज़ करके हम सेंटेंस को कन्वर्ट कर देते हैं तो वो सेंटेंस अपने आप एक रिलेटिव क्लॉज में चेंज हो जाता है और हमारी ड्यूटी रहती है कि उस रिलेटिव क्लॉज को मेन क्लॉज के साथ जोड़ दें। इस प्रकार हम आसानी से रिलेटिव क्लॉज बना सकते हैं। थैंक यू।